Hello everybody, how are we doing today? Today I'm going to be showing you how to convert a video file that you already have stored on your computer into a format that will work with iPod touches and iPhone devices. It's a very simple process, and the first step that you're going to need to do is open up your internet browser. Once you've opened up your internet browser, go to www.videoora.com. It's V-I-D-E-O-R-A.com. It's a very simple, user-friendly, free software program that I've discovered, and it allows you to convert video files into anything that will pretty much work with Apple products, Sony products, Microsoft, Nintendo. There's a ton of different products you can convert for, but today I'm going to be showing you how to work with Apple products. So over under Apple, go down to Videoora iPod Touch Converter and click it. This will bring you to the Videoora iPod Touch Converter main page, and then click on the orange tab button towards the main top part of the section. Download now. You can download this program for Windows, and you can also download it for Mac, which is also a pretty nice feature about Videoora. Once you actually have the setup file downloaded onto your computer, you can exit out of your internet browser. This is the file that we just downloaded from the internet, Videoora iPod Touch Setup. Double-click on that. Now that we're into it, click Next. I agree. I'm going to uncheck the YouTube downloader. Next. Now that we're at the destination folder, you can actually change where you want your program to be saved to. You can click Browse if you want to change the location, or you can simply leave it as it is. Click Next, Install, and in just a few seconds we'll have our video or program onto our desktop or wherever you save your files to. Alrighty, and now that we actually have our video or program downloaded onto our computer, you can double click it and open it. Alrighty, and now that we actually have our Videoora program opened up to its main page, there's a few things that you can do from here. First, over towards the left of the main page, there's three different methods of conversion. You can convert a DVD if you actually have the hard disk copy of the video that you're trying to convert. Right below that, you can convert a video file, which is what I'm going to be showing you how to do today. And then right below that, you can convert an online video. I found online videos to be a little bit sloppy and a little bit more difficult to work with, not always what you want it to be, so try and steer clear of online videos. Go right back up to Video File right here and click on that. Now scroll towards the right side of this main page and click Convert New File. Now there's two different modes that you're actually able to work with. There's normal mode, which is pretty much just trying to get the basics completely out of the way. You just want to be able to do the simplest conversion possible. And then right below that, there's power mode. For power mode, it's for people that understand just the basic terms of computers, so I'd recommend clicking on power mode. Now there's five different steps that you're going to actually need to take part in to actually convert your video file. The first step is actually finding a file that you want to convert. If you have a file stored onto your hard drive already, click Select File. Today we are going to be converting Step Brothers because I have the movie Step Brothers already downloaded onto my computer hard drive. Now for output directory, you can change by browsing where you want to save the output file to. This will be the completed iPod Touch or iPhone version of the video file. Right below that you can choose the title of the file. Let's title this one Step Brothers iPod version. Now right below the title you have device. There's a couple different devices that you can actually convert this video file to already in this program. iPod, iPod Classics, iPod Nanos, iPod Touches, iPhones, and Apple TV. We're going to select iPod Touch second generation. Right below that, there's a few different formats and different qualities you can actually select your video file to be converted to. I'm going to leave mine on the top setting already because that's the favorite one that I've found so far. Once you have all your settings completed, go over to the right and click Start Converting. If you want to convert more than one file at a time and start up a lineup queue, then right above that you can click Add to Queue, so you can be able to convert more than one file at a time. We're going to click Start Converting, and then now it'll bring you to a page. Click View Conversion Progress. Now it shows you your progress with a status bar. It says Converting Step Brothers iPod version. It says the time remaining, which is 2.5 hours, which is pretty good for about a movie that's about 2 hours long. And then also over here it says completed. Once the video has actually started its conversion, it'll show you the completion percentage. Alrighty guys, and now that we actually have our video file converted into iPod Touch and iPhone format, it should look something like this. Open up your iTunes account and go to the left where it says Library. Under that, click Movies. Now that we're in the movie section of iTunes, you can simply drag and drop your newly converted video file into that movie section. It should immediately start the upload. Okay, and now that we have Step Brothers uploaded onto my iTunes account, the next time that you plug in your iPod Touch or iPhone device and sync it with your iTunes account, it should transfer the video file over to your device. It's the simplest, easiest, and safest method I've found. Hopefully this helped you guys out. If you want a little bit of tip on where you can actually find videos, check the more info section to the right of this video. Hope you guys have a great day. I'll talk to you later.